Welcome, Cash CPT. So good to have you join us today, man. How are you doing?
Thank you very much for having me. I'm fine, thank you, and yourself?
I'm doing so good. I'm doing really well. Really looking forward to the Youth Day concert coming up and seeing you perform. I actually, admittedly, was recently introduced to you and I have been obsessed. I have to admit, I've been so obsessed, bro. Like, really into your music, really loving what you're doing as well. Love how you're repping Cape Town and all your stuff that you do and all the moves that you make. Let's get into the first question. So you've been consistently releasing for the last while now, and Cape Town Radio tape is a firm favorite within, you know, the hip-hop and the R&B community. So how are you moving with your stardom? How's it going for you being Cash CPT?
Thank you very much. So I won't lie, for the past 3 years I haven't really been releasing any music with my team, because we've been trying to just build or get to a level rather sonically where we're all happy and we feel like it's something different to bring to the table. And we dropped my first project last year December, on the 4th of December, and that was Cape Town Radio, and that was the first body of work where I was able to showcase everything that I've been working on amongst like the past 3 years. And through that time, the response has been, ever since we dropped, it's been crazy. I've been getting love from all over, like from South Africa to Namibia to like Zambia. Like I get messages from so many people now, just saying how the music has helped them or how they believe in where it could go. And it's really inspiring for me to also see that, because after putting in so much time into a project and seeing how much change it's been able to make in a positive way, that's been like the highlight of all of this. So it's making me hungry for more, like to make more good positive changes, if anything. It's exciting.
Yeah, man. And I have to just say that I really appreciate that, because I think that is what we need in Cape Town and South Africa, you know, that positive influence, especially when it comes to the hip hop R&B space, because it's rare and it's really great to see a guy doing that in particular. So keep on going. So you spoke about the highlights. Let's talk a bit about your challenges. Have you faced any challenges being young and also being a hip hop artist in South Africa?
Yes, I don't usually announce this, but I had a child with my partner at the beginning of Corona, so that's how lockdown started. So already with how Corona affected the economy and everything, it was kind of a weird spot to try and figure out how to move on forward from. But I had my team with me, especially my manager Nav, who helped a lot. I had a good support structure that backed me. So it wasn't just the music I was focused on, but I also told myself, like, I'm not gonna give up the music just because of any obstacle. Like it was motivation to just figure out how to figure a way to progress forward. And I feel like just with the people that I had around me, it was really possible. They backed me and they kind of reminded me whenever I was at the edge of giving up or anything. So it's been a journey, I won't lie, and I've learned a lot about the more music. I've learned a lot about myself. It's been like a growing experience, I would say, and it continues. So like, yeah,
it's gonna continue for the rest of your life. That's a commitment to parenthood. And congratulations, man. It's really, really beautiful. And I think that you are making your family proud, you know, and making the rest of us proud. So you gotta keep on keeping on. You've also been spending a lot of time in Joburg, and you know, people talk a lot about the different scenes, Cape Town versus Joburg, and what, you know, what's good about it, what's bad about it. Have you found that there is a difference, and can you speak on that a bit?
So I definitely can pick up on the difference. Like the energies are very different when in Joburg and in comparison to Cape Town. But one thing that I did notice is, if anything, there's more hype around the events and the projects that are happening in Josie. And I suppose you could say because there's more industry that side, but I also do see a possibility of, like, it's an opportunity to create what isn't here in Cape Town. So if anything, to broaden on what could become something much bigger than what it already is. And that's kind of what the team and I are trying to push, like, especially in Cape Town, because everyone's moving down to Cape Town now from Neighborbrook. So from here, we're gonna try and show everyone that we can make not a Joburg, but we can show like what a Cape Town is. When people come here, they expect like the same energy in a sense, but in a different space, if anything.
See what Cape Town has to offer. And I love that you said that we're not replicating or imitating what Joburg is doing, because the Cape Town sound sonically is just like, it's so different and it's so dope, and it's like bubbling under, you know. So we just need to really put a lot of energy into that. I always have a conversation with our great Drive host Kayeezy, and I always ask him, why haven't you moved to Joburg, like, you know, why? And he's like, nah, there's so much to do in Cape Town. Like, I look at Youngster CPT as well, and he's been pushing the Cape Town scene. So it's really great to see somebody that's younger also for that agenda.
Blessings, and I agree with you fully, 100%.
So how important is collaboration in creating music? I think that there's magic there, but maybe not that many people are keen on it or doing it.
Personally, I work with anyone who's willing to work, and I never ever, like, I always try my best to try and cancel my pride out of the situation. So most people I come into contact with, I'll never ever try and be like cocky in the room. I'll try and always like listen more than speak. It's something that I've picked up over the years, because I used to be someone that would try and just take over and make appearances for myself as soon as I walk in. But now it's more like energy. So I work based off energy. If the energy is good, then we can make magic together. Like, I don't see any barriers that prevent music from being made, especially for collaboration, because I'm always down and the team's also down beyond music. Like, we try and get involved in as many spheres that we can, because we try and push like in every direction. Don't believe in any limits type of vibes. So I'm like, in terms of collaboration, I feel you're in Cape Town, I want to try and instill an openness about collaborating with each other, because I feel a lot of people just keep to themselves once they get like a bit of like audience or whatever. I just want to try and integrate each other's audience into each other, and not just in music, like in a creative space where all creatives can kind of be involved and help each other out. Like a hub of creatives, and just like kind of push it.
I love the thinking there. I absolutely love that, a creative hub. And that's how we grow. That's how we grow our industry here. That's how we support one another and create the safety and the room to be able to continue making music or whatever it is that you want to do, right? So speaking about creating magic together, you've worked with Baker on a few of your hits. And, you know, they say every artist has his magic producer. So, for example, you have Michael Jackson and Quincy Jones, and then you have Justin Timberlake and Pharrell. So is he your magician?
I would definitely say that. Like, if anything, Baker, if you went from my best friend to my big brother. So if anything, it's I have a lot of, like, I have two big brothers now, and I have like a family, but obviously not like a family that I've grown with, like, if that makes sense. And Baker is someone that helped me find my sound personally. He was with me from the beginning, so I was able to develop with him because he gave me the patience. And then you get Nav that helped me. He made me aware of the possibility of broadening my sound sonically, because as an artist, I feel, or creative rather, you always feel like you get to a point where there's only so much that you can do, or you can only take something this far. And I feel like just because of those two gens specifically, I was able to try and break barriers sonically. Like, I can even hear it in the music that I'm making now. And Baker's definitely that guy. And Nav even like produces with Baker sometimes, so it'll be crazy. Like, we have a few tracks that all three of us have worked on, and it's just, like, I won't lie, without them, I don't really have my sound, but it's because of them that I have the sound that I have, if anything.
Yeah, that makes sense. And I love that you give them credit for your growth and for your discovery, because it's teamwork, right?
Definitely.
So tell us about your latest single. How exciting. Tell us what Ops is about.
Okay, bless up. So Ops was made about the beginning of this year. Baker and I came back from Joburg with just him and I. We came back from the team. And as soon as we got back, we had a Corona scare. And it was just before Christmas. So we were locked in for 2 weeks. We quarantined at my place. And we would obviously just try and fill in the time with... I don't usually play console games, so like we play Xbox, we play this Xbox. Our families would bring us food through the window and stuff, and then we'd record a lot. So Ops was, it was very much experimental. It started off as a freestyle that we just posted on IG to like let people hear that, yo, we also rap and stuff and we make this type of sound to test it out. And the feedback that we got from just releasing the snippet alone was quite good. So then we worked on it a bit more and added a second verse. And then like we asked another close friend of ours, he's called Jopa. And he's quite dope also. He's a model slash influencer, creative. And he shot a video for us and it went crazy on the socials. People were messing with it. They were messaging all of us asking when we're gonna drop it. So we like, the team took it. We took it upon ourselves to make a visual for it, which we shot already. And it's crazy with our good friend Torn Fussel, who's been shooting a lot of visuals with us. And all I can say is it started off as fun, and it with the love that we've gotten from such a project, it's crazy. Like to see a passion project or like a project that you don't intend to like be what people make it out to be do so well. It's crazy to see. So the feedback's been amazing. Yeah.
I love your excitement when you talk as well, because it gets me so hyped. I'm like, yes, man, let's keep on making music and keep on making a name for ourselves. Cash CBT, that's awesome. Lastly, I just want to find out if you have any message for the youth, because Youth Day's coming up, you're performing. I know you're going to bring something fresh and great. So what message do you have for the youth of SA?
This is the message that I'd like to tell you. In life, there's going to be a lot of people that don't believe in you. And there's going to be a lot of times where you believe in yourself, but no one around you will be able to see your vision. And in times like those, just surround yourself with people that love you and that believe in you. Whether it be one person, whether it be your mom, whether it be your dad, or anyone, it doesn't matter. As long as you're surrounded by love, and as long as you never give up on yourself, I promise you anything's possible. And it will always be like that. Like, never ever give up. Never ever give yourself a reason to give up. Always push, always have a reason to go on. And like, follow your heart. Always follow your heart. Don't do it because someone else tells you to do it. Follow your heart, boys. Yeah.
Love that. Thank you, Cash CBT. I'm looking forward to your performance. I appreciate your time and I can't wait to see all the music going forward.
This is Good Hope.